Joel, how you doing today?
Hey, I'm good. How are you?
I am very excited. I love this show. Just in case people don't know what Mystery Science Theater 3000 was and is, tell them the basic concept of the show.
You know, Mystery Theater is a show that features kind of like our own comedic art form, which is called movie riffing, which is basically saying stuff while a movie is playing and interacting with the movie in different ways. And so the show was about a guy who was trapped in space against his will, and these mad scientists were making him watch terrible movies because they were trying to find the worst movie in the world to then take over the world. And the way I explain it, it's that show where there's little silhouettes at the bottom of the screen saying...
You're sitting there, you're watching these movies and with two other guys, Tom Servo and Crow. Is it improv?
Well, it's a really... Oh, Peggy.
Hey, Peggy.
My dog's acting up. We started the show locally at the end of the 80s on a local TV station.
Oh, really? Okay.
And when we started, you know, it was really unclear how much could the audience multitask. And so when we started, it started obviously really small with just saying a few things, you know, having a host segment and then us sitting in there and occasionally throwing lobbing ideas in there too. You know, between Josh Weinstein and Trace Beaulieu, who are both really funny guys, mm-hmm. It became clear I wasn't that great at improvising and I wanted us to write it all.
Right.
And that worked really good because we were able to kind of bring up the quality of the show.
How did you meet those other guys?
I recruited them from the Minneapolis comedy scene. You know, back then, okay. Minneapolis had a ton of stand-up. I just got incredibly lucky by inviting those guys to come along.
This show must have been incredibly economical, too, to produce because... Basically, it sounds like you guys were doing it on a local level, and I can't imagine, except for, you know, a few minor tweaks, I can't imagine it was that much more expensive on a national level, and I bet Comedy Central like that.
Yeah, you know, our budget, I think when we started, was about 35,000 episodes.
Oh, wow.
Might have made 50 bucks a show, maybe, when we were at the local TV channel, and I was doing, you know, building sets and building the robots. I was having to do all that stuff.
So you made the robots?
Yeah, man.
That's pretty crazy. Those were so Tom Servo and Crow were the original. Were those the original robots?
Yeah, you know, money was coming in the door, so we were able to kind of refurbish and fix up all the robots. And they're all the original pieces from what I made. But Trace Beaulieu, who's actually really very talented, went and he took Crow and refurbished Crow and made him much more streamlined. I did Tom Servo and Gypsy.
I'm surprised with the extra money that Tom Servo didn't get some sort of skeletal system in his arms.
Yeah, you know, we had to skimp on that.
Let me ask you, what was your favorite episode that you did?
There's some that have emerged through the mist of time, like Manos, the Hands of Fate is really famous because we kind of discovered the worst movie ever made.
Mm.
And in some ways, that movie kind of took over. And it's such a strange, weird movie. And that's one of the few times in the show we really go, God, we're really sorry. This is really terrible. I think Mitchell is one that people really talk about a lot and really like, and I think that one's funny.
If there was a more modern film that you could bring the guys to and kind of riff on, what would it be?
Oh, man, I don't really know. I think usually, you know, I get asked that question, and there's kind of a formula for answering it, which is you take kind of the movie, the big blockbuster movie that has failed, and you put that in. Like, for instance, I say, John Carter of Mars.
All right.
So that's kind of the formula for my answer.
Okay.
But I don't want to cheat. It's kind of a cheat. You know what I mean?
Right.
I'm pulling back the curtain on how some of my business works. But, part of the secret, I think, of Mystery Science Theater and Cinematic Titanic is showing people a movie they've never seen before. And I think that's what's part of the fun of it is, like, we're kind of your weird tour guides into a a movie you've never seen.
Right.
You know, we've done, I mean, over 200 movies if you count Cinematic Titanic and Mystery Science Theater together. And
now, what's Cinematic Titanic?
Oh, well, that's the live show we do now. We go out and do live shows.
Oh, great.
And perform it. So it's me and the original cast from the show.
Oh, that's awesome.
We do it live. Yeah, we run bad movies and say stuff.
That's great. Do you have a website that we could
sure.
check out? I kind of want to keep tabs on that.
Yes, cinematictitanic.com.
Hey, Joel, this has been great, and I really appreciate you coming on. This is
thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Awesome. This has been huge. And by the way, does that guy just need a hug? He seems a little surly.
Yeah, you know, they're robots who are just trying to work out their humanity. So
yeah.
It's not very pretty sometimes.
No women on that planet either, huh?
No.
Yeah, I'd probably be a little surly,
but we
too.
We do take turns dressing up like ladies.
Oh, well, that's good. That's like a good Saturday night there after the movies.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Joel. I really appreciate it.
All right. Thank you. All right.